The chairperson believes exporting already processed products will create more jobs as well as increase the product's value. He accused those charcoal producers exporting these products of denying locals employment opportunities, as these would only benefit those outside the country.
We still have some of the charcoal process producers who are exporting charcoal in unprocessed to South Africa and some to Europe, and now you ship out the jobs to Europe. If you can have, let me say, 50 of this kind of charcoal company, you can able to employ more people. But now you have some companies that are buying charcoal in bulks, and then they can do the whole process that we are doing in Europe and South Africa. Instead of, we have a lot of people who are on the street looking for jobs, and then now you have some of the product that are shipped out of the country, and then people can manufacture those things that we are doing overseas on other part of the world.
The chairperson explained how government's intervention will assist the charcoal industry.
This charcoal camp industry where we are, maybe I have to give this task to Honorable Minister so that they can look at it. The government can stop or can ban that Namibia is no longer allowed unprocessed product, especially the charcoal, because the charcoal you don't need sophisticated and the higher skilled, but we can create jobs for our country. I think government needs to look at this and banning that no more, some of the things that can create jobs for our locally, for our people. It need to be looked at it so that if those companies, I'm not trying to play a monopoly, but I want to protect and also create jobs for our country.
Uno Investments produces about 1,200 tons of processed charcoal per month and exports to Europe. The charcoal factory is employing 53 people. Of these, 80% are women and the majority are residents of Arandis. Lionel Chavuta, NBC News, Arandis.